Hello, friends. Adam here with FED. Happy Fire Emblem Day, by the way. It is like, is it the 33rd anniversary of Fire Emblem? Awesome. So, cool. Celebrate by playing some Fire Emblem, I guess. Today, we're going to be looking at all of the inheritable skills in Fire Emblem Engage and ranking them. I'm doing this literally because I had a video pop up in my recommended that was like, hey, look, here's the inheritable skills and which ones you should do and shouldn't do and use and stuff. And I was like, oh my gosh, these takes are bad. So, here we go. I'm going to try and help you guys out here and help you pick good skills. I only have this tier list only has like the best version of each skill listed. But I will be talking about lower versions and stuff as we go. And yeah. Let's rate these in our tiers. We have top tier is a must have. These are inheritable skills that are always good for everybody. Super helpful skills are skills that are almost always good for most people. Big damage. These are your skills that are going to be great for your one-man army type units, your units that are meant to kill things. And then we have setup required. Something that sounds really good, but does require a little bit of help or maybe another skill or two to really make its full use. For fun, these are skills that aren't necessarily great, but I can see the fun in using them. And then we have the no tier. The absolutely not, why would you ever do this skill? It is not worth the SP. It just isn't, like, just hardcore not worth the SP, right? Sadly, this doesn't have the skills in any good order, so I'm just going to be going in the... It's like an alphabetical order, it looks like. So that's what we're going to be doing here. I'm going to pull up the Serenus Forest page for these skills so I don't lie to you about how much stuff costs, because that would be pretty awkward. Okay. So let's start with Advance. Advance for 500 SP... allows you to essentially get an extra space of move in situations where that would be nice. So you would think, oh, that's super helpful. But honestly, it's a for fun skill. Advance very rarely is going to actually give you plus one move. So if you want, you essentially have to be wanting to attack something that's exactly one space out of your attack range. And sure, that does happen, but it's pretty rare, and it's pretty rare that it's like actually a helpful thing, right? So I would not inherit it, personally. I do not think it's worth inheritance. If you're looking for fun, though, trying to make some fun use out of it, you go, girl. You go. You get it. Alacrity. Alacrity is a hard one for me, because I think a lot of people really like Alacrity. It's just really expensive for what it does in my mind. 3,000 SP is kind of a lot, especially for a skill that allows you to avoid counterattacks, I guess. But it's a player phase thing, which is fine. This game is mostly player phase, but you really need to have it on a unit that is fast. And not just fast, but a unit that is like gonna kill things in one round of combat, or else it loses its usefulness. Right, so if you don't have Alacrity on someone that is in a crit build with enough strength to kill in one round, or just enough strength to kill in one round and is actually going to be doubling, then it's not really worth your time. But if you do have that, it's very nice to be able to avoid the counterattack, right? So we'll put it in setup required. I think it needs the right setup, but it is totally, totally doable and totally potentially useful, I'll say. Not totally, but like potentially useful. All right, this arm shield. I'm not the biggest fan of arm shield, I'm going to be honest, guys. You just take less damage when you have weapon advantage. There are other skills that do what this does better. I'm going to say a big fat no for arm shield. The only thing it does have going for it is that it's incredibly cheap. It's incredibly cheap. It's only 600 at its max level. So if you want that for that, there's that. Yep, that for that, that's that. That's what I said. But without taking that, if you're willing to spend a little more SP, and SP is pretty plentiful now in with the well, I would not waste my time with arm shield. It gets invalidated by gentility later, like completely invalidated. Okay, fist focused or arts focused or whatever. Yeah, that's a big fat no for me. I don't care how much it costs. I'm very against increasing crit rate from enemies, even if it means increasing my own hit rate. Just no. I don't see that ever being actually useful. All right. Avoid plus 30. I'm going to put that into setup required. Now, you would think that's just like a super helpful thing, but really plus 30 avoid isn't that good unless you're already in a position to dodge things. So there's plenty of other skills I'd rather inherit over the avoid stuff. I am more keen on like avoid plus 15, which is only 1500. But even that's really expensive, right? Like, I don't know, man. Never mind. I'm not too hot on the avoid plus skill. It's very, very expensive. The only time I'd really consider using it is like early game if I have 500 SP laying around for like avoid plus 10. Otherwise, if you want to like get an over the top avoid build with like a thief or something and like a Corrin, Vein of Fog on like normal or hard, that's fun. But on Maddening, it just makes it so the unit just gets ignored completely, which I'm not the biggest fan of. All right, Axe Power. So the power skills, these, I'm just gonna grab them all really quick because I feel the exact same about all of them. And then Sword Power, which is right here. Yeah, Axe, Lance, and Sword Power. If you wanna deal fat damage, consistent big number damage, then the power skills are what you want to use. They are stupid expensive, and I mean it. They are incredibly expensive. At their max level, they are 5,000 SP in total. But you know, you can do the whole thing where if you get sword power 3 for 3,000 SP, then to get up to sword power 5 is just another 2,000. So there's that. You can do it like progressively throughout the playthrough, but 5,000 SP is a crap ton, but it is the most reliable way to get big damage. It doesn't rely on any other factors. It's just a fat plus 10. Very, very good for big damage. Outside of that, the minus 10 avoid isn't that big a deal. It doesn't bother me at all. So yeah, big damage. Love to see it. Okay. The avoid skills, the weapon specific avoid skills. I am not super hot on these, I'll be real. Not super hot on these. Crit is generally how you kill things in engage, unless you have like a stupid overpowered unit. And minus 10 crit's kind of annoying. It could be worse, I guess. I'm gonna say these are, all of these are just kind of a no for me. They're expensive for what they do, and they ultimately lower your damage output in a way that is kind of annoying to me. Yeah, I'm not the biggest fan of the agility skills. They are all no's for me personally. I'm sure someone has had some success and happy with them, combining it with like avoid plus 30 and then like sword agility or whatever. That's fun and cute. I am not a fan. Bow focus, yeah, no. Don't. Yeah, these might be my least favorite. The focus skills are just dumb. Do not like. All right, the guard skills. These are another set of inheritable skills that are just garbage. I'll be real with you guys. I do not like the guard skills. Let me just check how much SP they are. I don't remember off the top of my head. I can't remember if they're all the same between each different type. They're relatively cheap, I guess, right? It's like 1,000 at full rank, which is like okay, I guess. So I get that. But it's just like a few less damage for something the enemy has equipped. That is a big fat no-no in my mind. I'm sorry, guys. I don't think anyone's gonna disagree with me on this, though. All of the guard skills are kind of garbo. And by kind of Garbo, I mean super actually Omega Garbo. I think they're very, very bad. I'm sorry, I'm just trying to find them all. Those are guard skills, right? That's what those are, I'm pretty sure. I could be wrong. Someone correct me on that if I'm incorrect. Oh, there's Sword Focus. Get that in there. And there's Axe Guard. Okay. Yeah, the guard skills are all garbage. Don't waste your time. At least I wouldn't waste your time. All right. Break Defense. Break Defense is, at the very least, interesting. I think there is, it's a little expensive for 2,000 SP. You probably would get more damage out of it than you would, say, a Momentum. It does cost more than Momentum, though, but also it is situational. I think it could be... I could see some niche uses where, like, you use it with, like, someone who has Leaf, so they have a lot of Weapon Triangle access. I feel like it would shine on something like a Wyvern Knight. Who also has good weapon triangle access, or even an arts user, a key adept, or chi adept, or whatever it's called, also has a solid time using break defense. It does increase your damage by a significant bit, if you can activate it. So I will put it in big damage, I think, but it'll probably be like bottom of big damage. Build plus 5. I would almost never inherit this. For me, it's a for fun thing if I want to use like a heavy weapon on a low build unit. All right, Canter, our first must have. Not necessarily Canter Plus. Canter Plus is a bit overkill and it's just, really expensive. But Canter in the early game, as soon as you can get it, makes the game way easier. And like plus 2 move after attacking is stupid. It's so good. Movement is the best and most important stat in all of Fire Emblem, like, ever. And Engage is no different. So just getting plus 2 move is crazy good. Crazy good. Okay, so... defense plus 5. I will say it's like a setup required kind of thing. It's good if you want it. I think I need a new tier. We need a new tier here. And this is the, like, if nothing else tier. If you don't have anything else to put in a slot, like, sure. And that's like defense plus 5. Don't love defense plus 5. But, if you really, really... like, say Ike is the only bonded emblem you have with a character, sure, inherit defense plus 5 or defense plus 1, 2, or 3 or whatever for relatively cheap, and you're good to go. Just like a simple, easy throw-in skill. All right, Demolish. Oh gosh, Demolish is... it's so cheap, but like, why? That's such a niche thing. How often are you ever going to need that, right? How often are you ever going to need that? Okay. I believe this is Dexterity plus 5. And that comes from Lucina, right? Check the cost on that. 2,000 SP for Dexterity plus 5. I would pretty much never... I won't put it in no. I guess I'll put it in like for fun tier. Because I guess it would help you have like a little extra crit, which is kind of funny. But it's totally invalidated by, speed and dex plus 5. So, that's way more expensive, but that's just kind of how it is. Them's the breaks. Divine Pulse. Divine Pulse is surprisingly cheap for what it does. Surprisingly cheap for what it does. The base one is only 250 SP, but the real good stuff gets when you Divine Pulse Plus, which is 500 SP, which is like nothing, right? Super helpful. I don't think it's a must-have. I don't think every unit should have Divine Pulse Plus, but I think just making it so it, like, more reliable hits with your like Ivy or something, or other units who are going to be using like the Freeze Staff or maybe the Fracture Staff or Entrap. super helpful. Turning a, it's always really funny when you can take like a 20% chance to hit and just like ignore that and just hit anyways because Divine Pulse activates. Dodge plus 30, like no, why would you? I'd probably put that at the bottom. All right, Draconic Hex. Draconic Hex is insanely helpful, dude. Draconic Hex is expensive, but it is very much worth what you get out of it. 2000 SP, but it inflicts minus 4 to all foes' basic stats, which is incredibly nice for taking care of bosses. And that it even works on like the final boss and stuff. So Draconic Hex is very much worth the SP. Very helpful. Very good. All right. Dual Assist. Dual Assist only works on backup units, right? Or I guess the whoever has the Lucina emblem ring, but we're talking about inheritables here. So Dual Assist Plus is what you really want for the reliability of it, for the 70% chance to activate. That's 2,000 SP in total. I don't hate this, but I'm gonna say, I'll put it at the bottom, like big damage. It definitely helps you deal big damage with your entire army if you have it rolling. But the problem is you have to be on a backup, right? Obviously, very potent on like a hero or something like that. That brave assist, but I wouldn't prioritize it over other damage dealing skills for units. I mean, it helps. I guess it could help a unit be like a good support unit, but I don't know. I don't love having it on other units, but if you went crazy and did like an all backup, all hero, all dual assist playthrough, you would just shred enemies super, super hard. Dual support. Dual support's interesting. I've never tried to inherit it and use it in any capacity, I'll be honest. I think it's only going to be good on... I think it's going to be good. It has potential to be really good. But it really needs to be on the right unit. It really needs to be on the right unit. Like, Alir loves dual support because he can support literally everyone. But there are other units who don't have as many supports that don't necessarily want to use it. So, setup required because you're required to have good bonds with different allies, but... I do like it though. I do like it. It is like a big avoid stacking, which can be good, but also can be kind of annoying. I'm not sure how I feel about it entirely, actually. Favorite food, super helpful. It's free. You only want it on one unit though, because you only get one meal, unless you get lucky with Boudet, which. you're probably not going to get lucky with Boonay, let's be honest with ourselves. But it's a thing that can happen. But yeah, you just want it on one unit. And yeah, it's super helpful to be able to just engage right away. With a dance, you can keep like Bonded Shield up for 8 turns straight if you want with the use of one dance. So it's good stuff, man. It's good stuff. All right. I believe this is, again, sorry if I get these wrong. I'm still, some of these pictures I'm not super familiar with because I don't use them very often. I believe this is Assembly Gambit though. 1500 SP for it is kind of annoying, but it's just like drag back on the enemy, which is cool. I think it's, for me, this is a for fun skill. I think it does have some utility here and there, maybe pulling enemies off of avoid tiles and whatnot. But it is a for fun skill, definitely. All right, Gentility. Gentility, I think, is... do I want to put it in super helpful? It's just a flat, minus 5 damage taken, which is crazy. Absolutely crazy, dude. Pairs really well with, like, Ike, I believe it's kind of expensive, though. Let me look at the cost. I think it's, like, 2,000 SP. For the base version, and then Gentility Plus brings it up to 3,000. So it's an extra 1,000 SP for minus 2 damage taken. I think that the really selling point though is when Erica on the map engages and anyone has this, it becomes the gentility and bravery plus, you know, becomes like blue skies plus. So you also deal 5 more damage, which can be super helpful. I'm just gonna leave it in super helpful. I think it's a great skill if you want just like some reliable defense and then some occasional plus 5 offense, you know, attack when Erica engages. All right, Geosphere. I'm gonna be honest, guys. I'm gonna be honest about Geosphere. I'm kind of why use Geosphere when you could just use Gentility? Gentility is a little more expensive. Geosphere is only 1,000 for the plus version. But Gentility for the extra 1,000 is like not situational, it's just always active, which I prefer that. This to me, it's not like a no skill. I think it definitely has its use, but it's definitely a for fun skill. Headlong Rush. I'm gonna say this is like, if nothing else, kind of skill. It has its uses. It's like really cheap though. It's like only like 200 SP, I think. I mean, double check that. Yeah, Headlong Rush is only 200 SP. It can be really nice to avoid getting frozen, especially on like chapter 23, I believe it is. Is that chapter 23? Yeah, chapter 23. It's very nice not to get frozen by all the Griffin and Royal Knights that are running around with freeze staffs. But yeah, to me, it's like if nothing else. All right, Healing Light. This is a skill that I've seen people say is really good and you should inherit it. And like, it's only 200 SP, so I get that it's like, okay, whatever. but like, I don't know. To me, it's a for fun skill. You should never prioritize getting Healing Light. You should be using your SP on something better. Yeah, I'm gonna put it in no. Just like, don't waste your time with it, dude. All right. Hit plus 10, 15, 20, 30, whatever. Super helpful. Almost every unit would appreciate it. But not every unit needs it, you know? But hit rates, especially on Maddening, can be a bit frustrating when you're sitting in the 60s and 70s. So, Divine Pulse Plus is pretty much just better statistically, I believe, than hit plus 30. But it doesn't hurt. You know what? I'm actually going to move it down. I'm going to put it at the top of if nothing else. Because there's other skills that are just be more helpful for you in the long run. Like Divine Pulse Plus, which is cheaper. It just requires you to get to bomb level, you know, I think it's 19 with Byleth, which is crazy, but I think that is better than hit plus 30. Holdout. Even the lower versions of Holdout, super helpful. I'm going to put it like here, I think. Definitely not a must have, but it's super helpful. I quite enjoy Holdout. It allows setting up things like Reprisal and Wrath very easy. And increases survivability, which is nice. I like that. All right. I don't even remember what the skill is called. I know it's the one that damages Holy Stance. That's what it's called. No. Holy Stance is not worth a slot. It's cheap. And I don't know. Holy Stance plus is nice for, I guess, 50% damage to corrupted foes, but I don't know. I just wouldn't waste my time with it. HP plus 15. I'm gonna say this is a, if nothing else, kind of skill. It's nice with a reprisal user, especially if you have like a weak mage using it so that they can like not get one shot by stuff. But otherwise, it's kind of a throwaway skill slot in my mind. Same goes for this. Oh, the proficiency skills, is that what it's called? It's not called proficiency. It's like I just never use these. what are they called? I gotta remember what they're called, so I don't lie to you guys. Precision. The precision skills. These are dumb. I don't like them. The precision skills are silly gooses. I would not use them. Personally. Alright. Life Sphere. Life Sphere, to me, is a for fun skill. I don't see why you would ever go out of your way to get it, but if you feel like it, it can be kind of nice to just wait and get a bunch of HP back, right? So, it's pretty expensive for what it does, honestly. Alright, Light Sphere. This half chance of receiving a critical hit. I mean, like, no. not worth. Lineage is hard, man. Because I'm pretty sure, like, after you're, like, one level ahead of the enemy or something, it stops being useful. It's something like that. I'll put it in if nothing else, though. I'll put it in if nothing else. Because it's like, only 200 SP or something like that, so... If you really want a skill to throw on for only 200 SP that gives you some little benefit, sure, go for it. Let's look at... Next we have... Oh, this is Lost Item from Byleth, I believe. Or it's called Lost and Found. It's cheap, but, like, why? Just why? Luck plus 12. This is a for fun skill only if you're, like, trying to maximize your Anna... Your Anna procs for money. Alright, yeah, this is big damage. It's really consistent player phase damage. It relies on the enemy having a lot of defense, but once you get, like, there's nothing funnier to me than watching Fram run up to a general with a million defense and her just shredding it because of Lunar Brace and the Lunar Brace Plus. It's really expensive, but it's not as expensive as going for the power skills. So it has that going for it. And the cheaper, and if you go for the lower version, like I'm talking about like the lower version, the higher version is actually the same price, I believe. Altogether, yeah, it's 5,000 altogether. But that also can turn into Solar Brace Plus or Eclipse Brace Plus, which is kind of cool. Definitely big damage. I prefer it over like break defense, but I think I like the power skills more at this point. They're more consistent throughout your playthrough. Magic plus 5. It's just really expensive, man. It's really expensive to justify it. And I just can't. It's the same cost as the power skills and has half the effect, essentially. Which is just stupid. Magic plus 3 is 3,000 SP. Like, no. This is a for fun skill, but you're going to get way more damage out of a ton of other stuff. Mentor, I'm just going to say is a no to that one. Momentum plus, big damage increase. I think I like it a little more than break. I like it more than break defense because it's more consistent. But I think Lunar Brace tends to do more damage overall. I don't know what this is. I don't know what that is. I'm gonna put it down there for now because I can't remember or I don't know what that is. Is there? Like, it looks like it's like move plus 1, but I have no idea what that's supposed to be. So excuse me for that. Pair up is setup required. You really only need pair up on someone who's like a tank. It's really expensive. You have to get to bond level 13, I believe, with Corrin if you want to grab it. But if you do, it makes it really easy to survive enemy phases with a lot of chain attacks. Perceptive plus, no. Just no. Just no. Player Phase of Void, my favorite. High Player Phase of Void. Don't get me wrong, like if you're using Marth, Perceptive is nice, but I just wouldn't go out of my way to buy it. It is really cheap though. It's really cheap. I'll put it in the if nothing else tier. It's really cheap. Quality Time. This is another one that's a if nothing else. Except for you might want it on like your dancer, but it can mess up like your wrath and your reprisal setups, which is kind of annoying. Reposition from your boy Ike. It's only 200 SP. I think it'd be super, super helpful. I wouldn't have it on all the time, but I think there's situational moments where you like you might as well snag it and put it on someone. Res plus 5. I'm gonna say no on that one, bro. Resolve. Resolve is cool. Cool enough, at least. I don't think it's worth 2,000 SP for a situational plus 7 defense and resistance. I'd much rather have... I'd rather just grab gentility, honestly. It's definitely fun, though. I'll put it in a for fun tier. It's a little too expensive for me to just say if nothing else, but definitely for fun tier. Resonance. I'm going to say no to resonance. I actually really dislike resonance as a skill. I often find myself annoyed at the damage I'm taking from resonance. So it's cool that you get to deal extra damage, but I would just rather get that extra damage elsewhere. I'll be honest. Speed plus 5. That's going to be our first of the first and potentially only of the stat boosting stills to go into super helpful. Speed plus is pretty cheap, all things considered. For the highest version, it's only 2,000, and you get plus 5 speed. People are going to say that, oh, why do speed plus 5 when you can just use speed taker? Speed plus 5 is a right from the get-go. You get speed plus 5. You don't have to kill things. It's very consistent. And really, you can only have speed. You really only want to have speed taker on like one, maybe max two units, I feel like, on the map. You might be able to get away with three, but you really want it on like only, I would say, max two units. So I think speed plus 5 is still incredibly good. Speed taker, I'll put right by it though. Speed plus 5 is, you know, like instantly good. Speed taker takes at least. It takes at least three turns to get to the point where speed plus 5 is at, and most likely is going to take more unless you're really going out of your way to feed kills to your speed taker unit. Staff mastery. I actually really like staff mastery for your staff units. I'll put it in setup required because it's only situational. It's like super situational. But it can be very nice. Just I'm not really worried about the hit rates for things because I'd rather just have Divine Pulse Plus for that. For like hit rates on freeze and break, but I really like the extra healing you get from staff mastery, allowing you to top off better with like fortify staffs and stuff like that is very, very nice. Putting on it's honestly kind of nice to have on a unit like Hortensia if you're going to use her for a lot of healing shenanigans. Yeah, staff mastery, man, it's pretty cheap too. Like the early. You don't like even need like the higher versions of it. Like the lower versions are still nice. Is this one? This is Star Sphere, I believe, from Tiki. And Star Sphere is weird, man. Star Sphere is hard for me to rate because it really can help any early game unit just like snowball. But I don't think I can put it in super helpful. But it's definitely better than if nothing else. I'll put it at the bottom of super helpful. Just know that like it's at the bottom of super helpful for a reason. Like potentially a tier down from super helpful, like in like the like a helpful tier or whatever. All right, strength dex plus 5. I'm not a big fan of these hybrid skills. Like double paired up ones just because they're so expensive, man. They're so freaking expensive. Like 8400 SP to get to the level 5 version, but even just like the base version is a full 700 SP. But that's only plus 1 strength. If you want to get to plus 3 strength with it and plus 3 dex, it's 4200. Like, I would honestly rather just have strength plus 5 at that point, which is still stupid expensive, or I guess strength plus 6, I should say, which is still stupid expensive, but it is much more reasonable to get going. The dex just doesn't matter as much to me. Yeah, I'm gonna put this in no. I wouldn't bother with that. Even strength plus six, I wouldn't bother with. I would just, honestly, I would just go for a power skill or with weapon sync. So yeah, I'll put strength in like if nothing else, but like really, I wouldn't use it. You know, no, it's gonna go right here and for fun. It's just too expensive for what it does. Unyielding. I've heard some people say unyielding is incredible. Oh, every unit should have unyielding. It keeps it so they're alive. It works really well with wrath, they say. What? The point of wrath? Or like, it works really well with reprisal. Like, are we playing the same game, guys? If you want to use unyielding plus, you're essentially saying that you want to deal less damage with your reprisal, if you're saying to use it with reprisal. You guys are silly gooses if you're saying that. I think unyielding plus is not worth inheriting ever. Not worth the SP. Not worth the SP. It's cheap, but like, why? Fine. Actually, since it's so cheap, we'll put it in if nothing else. But yeah, no. Vantage is a setup required kind of thing. If you're not killing with Vantage, then it's not worth. Let me rearrange this a little bit. Let's put like that there. Let's put like this here, probably. If you're not killing with that first attack, Vantage Plus becomes pretty much worthless. So. Requires a bit of setup, but if you get a good setup going with it, it can be really nice. All right, weapon sync from the Edelgard band is very nice. It can act as kind of like a pseudo power skill for bows, knives, and tomes, which is nice. The problem is though, problem is that it's only reliably used for some of those with when engaged. But, you know, it can be nice for like a bow user using Lin. It'd be a consistent plus 5 or 7 damage if you get the plus version. It's just really expensive. Really expensive. Same price as the level 5 power skills. But hey, I think it can equal big consistent damage, which I like. Wrath. Wrath is a setup required kind of thing. I think it's good, but you... Plus 30 crit alone isn't enough. It needs to work with other stuff. You gotta have like an engrave and a crit weapon to really make use of Wrath. All right, I believe this is adaptable. Is that what it's called? Adaptable, or adaptability, I should say. Adaptability is cool, but there's other things that do it better. It is cheap though. I'll put it in if nothing else. If nothing else, maybe. All right, Soren's Anima Master, or whatever it's called. Let me make sure I get the name of it correct. Anima Focus. It has some interesting effects, but I don't know, man. It's only 800 SP for what it does, too. It's kind of cool. I'll put it like near the top of if nothing else. I probably wouldn't spend my SP on it, though. No, it's going down into for fun. Assigned decoy, you can only have one assigned decoy on the map at a time, so if you have the Soren ring, you don't need to inherit assigned decoy ever. You only can have one on the map at a time. You can't assign decoy two different units. It removes the status from the first. So it sounds cool, like, oh, I could have assigned decoy on two sides of the map, that'd be really nice. It doesn't work that way. Just, it's a no. It's a big, fat no. Big fat now. Okay. I'll be real with you. I don't know. I don't remember what that skill is. That's embarrassing. I believe that is something from Veronica, but I can't remember what it is for the life of me. So that's embarrassing. We'll come back to that one. Book of Worlds. I don't even like Book of Worlds that much on Veronica user. This is definitely a for fun skill. Brute Force, big damage from Brute Force. It can allow some units like Lapis to actually kill things with crits. But it requires crits. So maybe actually I'll put it in setup required. It requires crits. Charm. Charm is interesting, you know, being able to have a more reliable chain attacks is cool, But it's still not a, if it was 100% for the chain attacks to hit, I would be all in on it. But the fact that it's only 90 just doesn't do it for me, man. Doesn't do it for me. It's only 800 SP though. I don't know. I could see this being if nothing else. But really, I'll put it in setup required. If you just need some backups ready to go. Plus 10 hit rate for him isn't awful. No, actually, just kidding. No, don't waste a slot on that. Don't waste a slot on that. We'll put for fun. Yeah, for fun. Sure. All right. I believe this is Decisive Strike. No. If you're critting, you're hopefully killing. Detoxify? Yeah, no. Detoxify is stupid. Just use an antitoxin or something. Being poisoned isn't the end of the world, generally. Groundswell, I hate Groundswell so much. I hate Groundswell. It ruined my one of my first Iron Mans. So I just have I hate it a lot. Heavy weapon or whatever it's called, heavy draw. I believe it's a heavy draw, heavy attack. Wow, that's kind of a boring name. I thought it was a heavy attack. All right. When making a physical attack, if an equipped weapon's weight exceeds unit's build, adds excess as damage, only up to +5. I mean, it's 3,000 SP. Like, what the heck, bro? Just use a power skill. No. Just use a power skill at that point. What are you doing with your life, game? I believe this is keen insight. Plus, you know, just deal extra damage with effective damage. No, just kill things with effective damage, please. Level boost. This is a for fun skill for me. It has some benefit, but generally I don't care for it. Too expensive to care. Quick riposte. I gotta look at the cost of quick riposte really quick. 2000 SP isn't bad for what it does. I'll throw it in big damage tier. Yeah, why not? I think quick riposte is pretty sick. Rally spectrum, super useful. Super helpful. I'll put it up freaking up here. Yeah, I'll put it right here. Rally Spectrum's dope. So you get to beef up a bunch of units, dude, every turn. It's just kind of expensive, I believe, right? The base version's only 1500, but if you want to get to the really good stuff, it's only 2000. It's only an extra 500. You know, 2000 SP to buff a bunch of units. It's kind of good, man. It's kind of freaking good. Reprisal, big damage. That's the most damage output you can, like the biggest damage output, man. SP conversion, I would say, is a must have. If it weren't so hard to get to. Veronica just requires like level 13 with Veronica or something. Let me double check this one online to you guys. But that's just like a lot. That's a lot of bond fragments. If you can get there though, it's really cheap. Super helpful though. I think I'll put it here. We'll put it here. I'm gonna move this down. We'll move this down as well. I like that better. Okay. All right, speed and dex +5. I think this one actually is relatively cheap. It's only 4,800 for both. But honestly, I'd rather just have speed +5, so no. Speed res +5, again, I'd rather just have speed +5. Strength and defense +5. This one is at least semi-interesting. I don't hate the idea of this one. But it's just so expensive that I can't justify telling anyone to get it. Surprise attack. Surprise attack is definitely a for fun skill. I don't seriously recommend getting it for anyone, but it can be fun to use, sure. And now these last two skills, they're going to kill me. I gotta know what they are. Why can't I remember what these two pictures freaking are? I'm gonna lose my gosh darn mind. I'm gonna lose it. You know what? Tell me in the comments what these skills are and tell me if they're good. Oh wait, is that block recovery? Is that what this is? Is this block recovery? Yeah, this is block recovery. Yeah, like whatever. No. That's what that is. It's block recovery. Don't waste your time with block recovery. Who cares? Block recovery is dumb as heck, bro. Don't waste your precious, precious stuff on that. And now I have no idea what this one is. I have no idea what this is supposed to be. Maybe I'm a dum-dum. But obviously, it can't be that good if I have no idea what it is, right? That's what I'm going to tell myself, at least. That's what's going to help me sleep at night. I may have gotten some of the I guess I'm not super familiar with the DLC skills and their pictures. Ooh, my belly just made lots of noises. I don't know if you're in that. Anyways, thanks for watching till the end, if you did. You're a legend if you did. If you didn't, and you just skipped here, that's cool. But I think you're obligated to subscribe if you skipped to the end. Yeah, help us reach 20,000 subs. That's cool. Yeah, I don't know if you guys heard that. That was my stomach growling. I'm gonna go get some food. I'm hungry. And yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe, like the video, comment. What did I do completely wrong with this one? I'd love to hear your thoughts. And I will catch you next time.